Hi, good evening, everyone.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Good.
Excellent.
And you?
I'm good, thanks for asking.
Okay.
Okay, so we are going to start with our class. This is our first class, and I'm really excited to meet you. It's really a pleasure having you tonight. Let me introduce myself. My name is Araceli Rosales, and I'm going to be working with you for this pre-intermediate module, okay? First of all, I would like to ask you, how are you doing with the platform? If you have questions or if you have had any problem working on the exercises?
No problem, teacher.
Okay, excellent. How about the others?
Excuse me?
Okay, what about the others?
Spanish, please, teacher.
Okay, we have here Chico Lázaro, we have Raquel, Brenda, Daphne, and Leslie, and you, Carlos.
Yes.
I just want you to tell me, how are you doing? Is everything good? Yes? Or am I speaking too fast? ¿Estoy hablando demasiado rápido?
Un poco, teacher.
Okay, sí, porque veo que los demás solo se me quedan viendo ahí, como que qué pasó, ¿verdad? Okay, bueno, les decía, mi nombre es Araceli Rosales y yo voy a estar a cargo de ustedes en lo que es este módulo del preintermedio. Si sienten que voy demasiado rápido, por favor, háganmelo saber. Y si tienen alguna duda o no me logran escuchar bien, igual, ¿verdad? Háganmelo saber para solucionar lo que son esos problemas, ¿ok?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, thank you. So, we are going to begin. Vamos a iniciar entonces. Como han estado trabajando en la plataforma, ¿verdad? Vamos a iniciar con lo que es la primera conversación. That is called, where are you from? Okay. Since we have on that conversation two friends introducing themselves, that's what I want you to do. Okay. Vamos a iniciar con la conversación que está en la plataforma que se llama Where Are You From? Y como ahí se están presentando, eso es algo que vamos a hacer nosotros acá también. ¿Ok? Necesito conocerles no solamente así por el nombre, pero también un poco más de ustedes. So, we are going to begin. And Let's go ahead and do it. Okay. Si en dado caso no logran escuchar, me avisan, ¿verdad? Para solucionar problemas, ya sean de audio o de conectividad. Okay.
Great, teacher.
Okay. Thank you. Hi. Veo que tengo aquí estudiantes conocidos, ¿verdad?
Yes, hi, teacher.
Hi, how are you? Yeah, and I can see Brenda too. Excellent. Okay, perfect. Okay, so let's begin with this short conversation, and then we are going to be working in breakout rooms, okay?
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the pre-intermediate course. This lecture, please call me Beth.
Lesson, participants will learn how to introduce themselves and others by listening to a conversation between two people who just met and are introducing each other.
Hi everyone, welcome to this class. We'll learn how to introduce ourselves and others. For you to learn how to do so, you need to listen to the following audio program. Remember that you may listen to the audio as many times as you need to, and don't forget to practice it as well. Let's pay attention.
Hello, I'm David Garza. I'm a new club member.
Hi, my name is Elizabeth Silva, but please call me Beth.
Okay. Where are you from, Beth?
Brazil. How about you?
I'm from Mexico.
Oh, I love Mexico. It's really beautiful.
Thanks. So is Brazil.
Oh, good. Sunhee is here.
Who's Sunhee?
She's my classmate. We're in the same math class.
Where's she from?
Korea. Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name again? Garcia?
Actually, it's Garza.
How do you spell that?
G-A-R-Z-A.
Okay, so you could see that here we have that conversation where we have two people introducing themselves. And what we are going to do right now, as I told you before, is to work in breakout rooms, okay? And let me just share that information with you. Okay, basically this is the conversation that we have, that we just listened to. Okay, so we are going to be working in groups of two, and something that I just really want you to tell me is where David is asking, where are you from? You're going to tell me the place of origin. Okay, your place of origin. So, for example, if you ask me, where am I from? I can tell you that I'm from San Marcos. Okay, I'm not going to tell you the country because I think that all of us are from El Salvador. Okay, todos somos de acá del país, entonces me van a decir su lugar de origen. En el caso mío, verdad, yo soy de San Marcos, so I'm from San Marcos. Some of you may tell me, I'm from Soyapango, or I'm from San Salvador, I'm from La Libertad, etc. Okay? And this is a really good opportunity to practice also your spelling. Vamos a estar practicando también cómo deletrean, es decir, el abecedario. So, how do you spell your last name? In my case, I would say my last name is spelled R-O-S-A-L-E-S. Okay? Eso es lo que vamos a estar haciendo ahorita, ¿ok? Vamos a practicar esta conversación corta, presentándonos nosotros mismos. En la pregunta, where are you from? Nos van a decir su lugar de origen. Y de igual manera, vamos a ir practicando lo que es el abecedario. A ver qué tanto recuerdan eso. ¿Ok? Is that clear for you? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, yes. Excellent. So we are going to start with the breakout rooms. Vamos a iniciar entonces con lo que son los breakout rooms. Voy a estar ahí escuchándoles. Y si en el caso que alguno me quede de tres, pues ya vamos a ver si alguien más se nos une, ¿ok?
Ok.
Ok, so let's begin. Okay. Okay, you're going to get an invitation. Van a recibir lo que es una invitación, ¿verdad? Para que se unan a los grupos ahí en Zoom. Solo le tienen que dar ahí en unirse.
Si quieren la comparto yo ahorita.
Ok, teacher.
Ah, vaya, Carmen.
La comparto yo ahorita al grupo de WhatsApp.
Okay. Sí, por favor.
Va, ok.
Ay, ¿qué pasó? Oh, que no tenemos la conversación, teacher. I don't have it. Ok, so let me just take a screenshot. Or let me share it with you.
Ahí está, en WhatsApp. Ahí está, compañero.
Ah, ya. Thanks.
Ah,
okay. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, teacher. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Vaya, Carlos, inicie usted con cualquiera de las dos.
Hello, I am Carlos Dominguez. I am new class English.
Student, you can say I'm a new student or yeah, your new classmate. Teacher, this conversation is model only. Yeah, this only is a model. You can follow the same model or you can change. For example, what I was telling you is that in the information where they are asking where are you from, you can tell me your place of origin, okay? Solo aquí donde les pregunta que de dónde es, me van a decir su lugar de origen, ya sea San Salvador, etc. Pueden seguir ese modelo o lo pueden cambiar.
Okay.
Okay. I am from Mexicanos. How do you spell that? Is Dominguez. D O M I N G U U E T.
Who or you?
Excuse me, teacher.
With the vowel, is it you or u?
It's you, you.
Okay. Okay, thank you. So I'll let you work in. Lo voy a dejar que trabaje.
Okay.
Ahora Esmeralda, sí.
Hola.
Okay.
Sorry, Brian, but you're getting cut off.
Hola.
Hola, se le está como cortando allí.
Hola.
Sí, se le escucha.
Tengo que escucharme.
Yeah. Casi que no le entiende.
Yeah, sorry Brian, but you're getting cut up. I don't know if you're having problems. Okay, he disappeared. So Brenda, tell me, how are you?
Yeah. Very good.
Okay, excellent. Nice seeing you again. Tamara, can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
Okay, excellent. So I want to listen to you practicing.
Okay. Brenda.
Oh. Hola.
¿Cómo se practicó?
Voy a empezar otra vez.
Okay.
Voy a empezar aquí. Hello, I am Brenda Mejia. I am a Never Club member.
Hi, my name is Tamara Ariana, but please call me Tammy.
Okay, where are you from, Mariana? Me dijo Mariana.
No, Tammy.
Oh, no, Tammy. Tammy. Okay. Okay, entonces la repito.
Okay.
Okay, where are you from, Tammy?
Sepango, how about you?
I am from El Salvador.
Your place of origin? Su lugar de origen, ¿cuál es?
I am from San Salvador.
Okay, I am from San Salvador.
Okay, I am from San Salvador.
Oh, I love San Salvador. It's really beautiful.
Ma'am, where are you from?
I am from El Salvador.
How do you spell your name?
K-E-R-E-N.
Okay, and you?
How do you spell your last name?
J-O-S-U-E.
Last name.
Is that your last name or your first name?
Last name?
Okay, your last name is Peña or Hernandez? Es el apellido.
Peña.
Okay, so how do you spell Peña?
Is P-E-M-A.
M or N?
N.
Okay, excellent.
I'm from in Santa Ana City.
Okay, how do you spell your name?
Last name.
No, name. First name.
Let's go. Sí, ¿verdad? San Martín.
San
Raquel.
Martín.
Perdón, San Martín.
I'm from
Let's
San
go.
Martín.
Okay. Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name, Lázaro, again?
Actually, it's Lázaro.
Your last name?
How do you spell your name? You spell that, es la pregunta.
How do you spell that?
L-A-C-A-R-O.
Lázaro. Yo pensé que Lázaro era nombre.
Es normalmente apellido. Nombre. Sí, en mi caso es apellido, sí. Lo practico con Raquel.
Sí.
Okay. No lo encuentro.
Ah, no lo tiene.
No, ya estaba tratando de ingresar, pero no me ingreso ahorita.
Raquel.
Hello.
There you have it.
Ahí está en pantalla.
Yes.
Ahí lo pusieron, Raquel.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello. Hello. I am Francisco Laza. I am a new club member.
Hi, my name is Raquel Garcia, but please call me Kelly.
Okay, where are you from, Kelly?
I'm from San Martin.
Oh, I love San Martin. It's really beautiful.
Yeah.
No, it's okay. Yeah, you can see Beth finished, okay. Then continue, then she continues.
Oh, good. Yeah. And some chicas.
He, that's a name. Ese es un nombre. Son he es un nombre.
Nombre.
Sí.
Oh, good. Estoy aquí para...
You can change the name instead of Son He. You can say, oh, good. Leslie is here.
Leslie.
Yes, and okay. Francisco can ask. Yes.
Yeah. Who's Leslie?
Excellent.
Oh, good. Leslie is here.
Okay. Who's Leslie?
She's my classmate. We're in the same my class.
Where is she from?
She from is Santana.
She is from?
She is from Santana.
Okay.
We're in
Santana.
Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name again? Garcia?
Actually, it's Lazaro.
Oh, how do you spell that?
L-A-C-A-R-O.
Okay, excellent. Perfect. Okay.
Who's Gerardo?
He's my classmate. We're in the same math class.
Where's he from?
San Vicente. Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name again? Guzman?
Actually, it's Guzman. Sí. Yes, Guzman.
How do you spell that?
G-U-Z-M-A-N.
Sí.
Okay, excellent.
Thank you.
And did you finish?
Yes.
Okay.
We finish.
Excellent. Please. Thank you.
I'm 18 years old. What is your favorite color?
My favorite color is white.
And how do you spell that?
W-H-I-T-E. Daphne, what is your favorite color?
My favorite color is black.
Oh, how do you spell that?
B-L-A-C-K.
Oh, okay.
And where do you work?
Ah, sí, es cierto, esta vez estaba. I don't work, Dan.
Okay, excellent. I was able to listen to all of you, and I can see that you're doing a really great job. So we are going to begin. I want to have volunteers. Necesito voluntarios para esta actividad. So do I have volunteers or do I have victims? ¿Tengo voluntarios o tengo víctimas? Tell me. Volunteers, so raise your hand. Otherwise, I'm going to choose.
Hi, teacher.
Excellent. Thank you, Carlos. Who are you working with?
Accounting.
No, I mean, ¿con quiénes estuvo trabajando? ¿De sus compañeros?
Esmeralda y Carmela.
Okay, so Carmela. Esmeralda and Carmela. Let's begin with you. Vaya, iniciamos con ustedes.
Hello. Hello, my name. Hello, I am Esmeralda West. I am a student. And you? Carlos.
Hello, I am Carlos Dominguez. I'm new class English. Modulo 1, intermedio. Intermedio, pero no sé cómo se dice en inglés.
Intermediate.
Intermediate.
Yeah, this is K.
Intermediate.
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 Okay. Where are you from, Carlos?
I am from Mexicanos.
Okay.
Esmeralda.
Okay. Where I am from? I am from El Salvador. I live in Soyapango.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. How do you spell that?
Dominguez. D-O-M-I-N-G-U-E-C. C.
Dominguez. Okay. And hi, Carmela. Excuse me. My last name is Hueso. Spell H-U-I-C-C-O. Hueso.
Okay.
Hi, Carmela. Where are you from?
Carmela, you're on mute. Okay.
Hi, Esmeralda. Nice to meet you. My name is Carmela Portillo. I'm from El Salvador. I live in Lourdes.
How do you spell that? Your last name.
Last name?
Yes.
Okay. R-T-A-L-L-O.
Okay. Okay. Nice to meet you.
Bye.
Only teacher.
Okay. Thank you.
Correcciones, teacher, please.
Yeah, can you spell your last name one more time, please? ¿Se puede leer su apellido una vez más?
Okay. P O R T I.
Uh-huh.
L, or.
Okay, the first vowel, is it O?
O.
Or. O. Yeah.
O.
Thank you. Sí, porque le escuché or. que ya eso es algo muy, muy distinto, ¿verdad? So yeah, sorry. That was the first thing that I got. So we have portillo. P-O, that's the vowel. O-R-T-I-L-L-O. Okay.
L-L-O. Okay. Thank you.
Excellent. Perfect. So now you tell me a number from 1 to, let me see how many I have, from 1 to 17. Esmeralda o Carmela, can you tell me a number from 1 to 17?
Esmeralda, 17.
17. So let me see who is 17.
No, no, sorry, teacher.
No, that's okay. 17 is Brian, but he's having some problems. So do I have another volunteer? So I think that we are going to continue with Gerardo. Gerardo Alfaro, okay? Let's listen to you and your group.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Con Gabriela y Jonathan.
Okay, so Gabriela and Jonathan. Let's listen to you.
Hello, I'm Gerardo Alfaro.
Hello, Gerardo. Where are you from?
I'm from El Salvador. I live in San Vicente.
How old are you? How old are you, Gerardo?
I'm 27 years old, and you?
24 year old.
I am?
I'm 24 year old.
Okay.
How do you spell that your last name?
M E J I A. ¿Me escuchan?
Sí.
In you, your last name?
A-L-F-A-R-O.
Nice to meet you, Gerardo.
Nice to meet you too.
Okay, and what happened with your other classmate? You said you were working with Jonathan too, right?
I'm here.
Okay. So, Jonathan, can you choose any of your classmates, please?
Okay. Hello, Gerardo. I'm Jonathan Guzman. I'm a new club member, right?
Member.
Hi, my name is Gerardo Alfaro, but please call me Gerardo.
Okay. Where are you from, Gerardo?
I'm from San Vicente. How about you?
I'm from El Salvador and I live in Cuscatlan.
Oh, I love Cuscatlan. It's really beautiful.
Oh, good. Gabby is here.
Who's Gabby?
She's my classmate. We're in the same math class.
Where's she from?
San Miguel. Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name again? Garcia?
Actually, it's Alfaro.
Oh, How do you spell that?
A-L-F-A-R-O. And you, how do you spell that? Your last name.
Is G-U-Z-M-A-N.
Okay, excellent. Perfect.
Thanks.
Okay, do I have another volunteer before we move? Anyone else? Okay, so we're going to have the last group that is going to be Lázaro, Chico Lázaro, Francisco Lázaro, okay? Let's listen to them.
Okay, hi, I am Francisco Lázaro. I am from El Salvador. I live in Santa Ana. The member of my group, Leslie and Raquel.
Okay.
Hi, Lázaro. My name is Leslie Ortiz, but please call me Leslie.
Okay, where are you from, Leslie?
Santa Ana. How about you?
I am from Santa Ana too.
Oh, I love Santa Ana. It's really beautiful.
Okay, let's continue.
Oh, good. Raquel is here.
Who is Raquel?
She is my classmate. We're in the same math class.
Where is she from?
San Martin. Let's go and say hello. Sorry, what's your last name again?
Actually, it's Lázaro.
How do you spell that?
L-A-C-A-R-O.
Okay, excellent. Okay, will you practice with Raquel? Or would that be it?
Raquel, hello, I'm Leslie Ortiz. I'm a new club member.
What happened? Let me see. Oh, there she is, okay.
Hello, Raquel.
Hello.
Hello. I'm Leslie Ortiz.
Problem connection.
¿Tiene el ejercicio ahí, Raquel?
Do you have the conversation? Okay, so there you have it.
Okay. Hello, I'm Leslie Ortiz. I'm a new club member.
Raquel. Okay, sorry, but she said that she's having some problems. Okay, so
hello.
Thank you. Hi.
¿Se escucha?
Sí, se le escucha.
Okay.
Okay.
My hello. Name is Raquel García.
Okay.
Where are you from, Leslie?
I am from El Salvador.
I live in Santa Ana.
Oh.
Where are you from?
Beautiful Santa Ana. I'm from in San Martin.
Oh. San Martin is really beautiful.
Yeah. Your last name, spell me.
O-R-T-I-C.
Ortiz.
You can spell your last name?
My last name. G-A-R-C-I-A.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Corrección, teacher, era can you? Porque era pregunta.
Sí, es una pregunta. Entonces, vamos a iniciar con el auxiliar can. Can you spell?
Can you spell your last name?
Your last name, okay. Another one that I noticed is that when you're saying your place of origin, I'm from, I am from, y luego from. La ciudad, okay. No decimos I am from in. So, you can tell me, I'm from San Martín, I'm from Santa Ana, I am from San Vicente, I am from Mexicano, sorry, I am from Soyapango, etc. Okay? Ese es el orden que vamos a seguir. El from, es decir, sujeto, verbo to be, from, más la ciudad. Okay?
Okay, okay.
Okay, so another question. So we said subject, then we're going to have the verb be, from, and the city or country, okay? That's the way that we are going to do it. I am from San Marcos. And we have Gerardo is from San Vicente. Who were from Santa Ana? ¿Quiénes son de Santa Ana?
I'm from Santa Ana.
So we have Francisco. Francisco, who else?
I am from Santa Ana.
Okay, so we have Alex and Leslie. Josué too? Okay, so you can see how many people we have from Santa Ana. Wow. Josué and Leslie. Did I spell your name correctly, Leslie?
Yes.
With Y, Leslie?
With Y.
Excellent, okay. And Leslie are from Santa Ana. So that's the way that we are going to be making sentences when we're talking about places of origin, okay? So you can see we have the subject, verb to be, the preposition from, plus the city or country, okay? We have, I am from San Marcos. Gerardo is from San Vicente. Francisco, Alex, Josué, and Leslie are from Santa Ana, okay?
Okay.
Any questions?
No questions.
Okay, so we're going to move to another topic. And this one may be sometimes kind of difficult. Why? Because we are going to be studying possessive adjectives. Okay, so we're going to watch the video and then I'm going to be explaining to you how we're going to be using these adjectives, okay? So let's take a look and watch the video.
No listen, teacher.
You cannot listen?
No, no, teacher.
Okay.
I don't know. No. No, teacher.
So let me just play it again. Let me know if you can listen, okay?
By the end of this lesson, participants will be able to understand and use possessive adjectives. My, your, his, her, its, our, their.
Today, we will go over the possessive adjectives. Let's listen and look at the chart.
Statements with be, possessive adjectives. Statements with be. I'm from Mexico. You're from Brazil. He's from Japan. She's a new club member. It's an exciting city. We're in the same class. They're my classmates. Contractions of be.
I'm equals I am. You're equals you are. He's equals he is. She's equals she is. It's equals it is. We're equals we are. They're equals they are.
Possessive adjectives.
My, your, his, her, its, our, their. I want you to pay attention to the possessives. In English, each person has its own possessive. So remember, I, my, you, your, he, his, she, her, it, its, we, our, they, their. For example, we say, my family, his mother, her car, our brother, and so on.
Okay, so this is the video that we have about possessive adjectives. Okay. So you can see here that we have statements with be. Tenemos lo que son las oraciones con el verbo to be, the contractions of the verb to be, and then we have the possessive adjectives. Let me see. I'm going to choose one of you, someone that hasn't participated. For example, we're going to have Tamara. Can you read the first sentence, please?
The
one we have here.
I'm from Mexico. Only I'm.
Yes.
I'm.
No. Continue.
I'm from Mexico.
Thank you. Brenda, the next one.
You are from Brazil.
Thank you. Karen.
He's from Japan.
Daphne.
She's a new club member.
Club?
Club member.
Thank you. Alex?
It's an exciting city.
Thank you. Gerardo?
We're in the same class.
And the last one, Leslie?
They are my classmates.
Okay, thank you. So you can see that here we have the statements with be. This is something that you studied in the basic level, how we're going to make sentences. Es algo que estudiaron en el nivel básico, ¿verdad? Cómo hacer oraciones afirmativas con el verbo to be. So who can tell me how we are going to be making these sentences? ¿Cómo hacemos estas oraciones?
Sujeto.
Okay, subject.
And complement.
Excellent. So now you can see that here we have the contractions of be. Josué Mauricio, can you read them, please? Josué?
Hello.
Okay, can you read the contractions, please?
I am. I am.
Okay.
You're. You are. He's. He is.
Thank you. Gabriela, continue.
Is equals she is. It's
equals it is. Where equals we are. There equals they are.
Okay, thank you. And then you can see that we have the possessive adjectives. Carlos, can you read them, please?
My, your, his, her, it, all, their.
Okay, excellent. So who can tell me what are possessive adjectives? ¿Qué son los adjetivos posesivos? Any idea?
Para mí, teacher, algo que me ayudan a expresar en inglés lo que me pertenece, o por decirlo así.
Ah, okay, yes. ¿Algún ejemplo?
This is my cup.
Okay. Excellent. What else?
It is my pencil.
Okay, perfect. Another example?
This is her car.
Excellent. Okay.
This is my dad.
Perfect.
That is my computer.
Okay, that is my computer. Perfect. So you can see here that we have the statements with be and possessive adjectives. And something that was mentioned on the video is that each subject pronoun has its own possessive adjective. Algo que mencionaban en el video, ¿verdad? Es que cada pronombre personal tiene lo que es su adjetivo posesivo. ¿Ok? So, para my, ¿cuál es el pronombre personal?
I.
I am.
I am.
No, I. Solamente I. El pronombre. Ok. Para your.
You.
His.
He.
Her.
She.
It.
It.
Our.
We.
We.
And their.
They.
Excellent. Vaya, ya sabiendo esto, no nos tenemos que confundir. Generalmente siempre sucede que están hablando de alguien, es decir, de una mujer, y dicen, his name is Sarah, for example. O sea, me dicen su nombre, pero aquí me dicen que es él y después dicen Sara, ¿ok? Y uno se queda, ok, so, is it correct? Yes or no? Or, estamos hablando de él y dicen, her, yeah, me dicen, her car is new. Ahí cuando me dicen her car, o sea, yo entiendo que el carro es de ella y no de él. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so, let's be careful on that. So, here we have the definition of possessive adjectives. Selena, can you read them, please? Can you read it?
Possessive adjectives are used to show possession or ownership or control. Really, we use them while we use them when we refer to people. This is more in the sense of, esa no sé, teacher.
Relationship.
Relationship, that y
ownership.
Ownership.
Okay, thank you. So you can see that here we have the definition of possessive adjectives, and it says that they are used to show possession or ownership of something. O sea, aquí tenemos lo que es la definición y dice que los adjetivos posesivos se usan para mostrar lo que es posesión o pertenencia de algo. Sin embargo, dice que cuando lo usamos, cuando nos referimos a personas, es más en el sentido de una relación que de pertenencia. ¿Ok? I know that we said my family, my father, my mom, my child or children, etc. But in that case, we are just showing relationship. En el caso de eso, ¿verdad? Es de la relación que tenemos nosotros, no de pertenencia. ¿Ok? Pertenencia puede ser los ejemplos que ustedes decían. My car, my computer, your laptop, your cell phone, our class, and so on. ¿Ok? Any question?
No.
Any question?
No question.
Okay, no question. Seguros?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Okay, sorry. So, this is something that we already talked about. Esto ya lo vimos, ¿verdad? Lo que son los adjetivos posesivos en inglés. So, you can see we have the subject, and here we have the possessive adjective. So, now, this is really important for you. Esto es muy importante que lo recuerden. It says that we use a possessive adjective with a noun, okay? Los adjetivos posesivos siempre, siempre se van a utilizar con lo que es un sustantivo, okay? So you can see that I have my book, his hands, your house, okay? Siempre que yo estoy usando adjetivos posesivos, van a ir seguidos de un sustantivo. Es decir, tengo mi libro, sus manos, tu casa, ¿ok? Porque si yo solamente les digo mi, queda inconcluso. Su o sus, igualmente, queda incompleto. O si les digo tú o tus, queda incompleto, ¿ok? So we always need a noun. Siempre necesitamos lo que es un sustantivo. ¿Alguna pregunta?
No,
no, teacher.
¿Seguros?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Ese yes no me suena así tan seguro. Sí, correcto. Ok, so, because of the time, porque ya va siendo casi hora, bien rápido se nos fue el tiempo, we are going to see the examples that I have here. Vamos a ver los ejemplos y mañana vamos a estar trabajando con algunos ejercicios. Okay, so you can see that here we have the following examples. Let me see. ¿Quién no me ha participado? Quiero ver. No, probably you already participated, but I'm going to have, let me see, Carmela, please.
I want to participate.
Oh, okay, perfect. Can you read the first three? Las primeras tres.
Mira, yeah, yeah.
Hello.
Excuse me.
Okay.
My sister is at work. Your father is friendly. His backpack is under the table.
Under the table. Okay, thank you. Continue.
Her parents are doctors. Is leader
title.
Is tired. Is misery. Our teachers are in a meeting. Their cats are in the park.
Okay, excellent. So you can see here that we have the possessive adjectives at the beginning, and you can see that next to them we have a noun. They have my sister, your father, his backpack, her parents, its title, our teachers, their cats. Como se dan cuenta, siempre tengo lo que es un sustantivo, porque yo, si digamos, yo solamente les digo mi está en el trabajo, ¿de quién estoy hablando? ¿De qué? De mi mamá, mi papá, mi hermana, mi hermano, mi gato, mi perro, etc. So, I need a noun. Entonces, necesito lo que es un sustantivo. Your father is friendly. Tu papá es amigable. ¿El papá de quién? You can say mine or yours, etc. His backpack is under the table. Su bolsón está debajo de la mesa. ¿El bolsón de quién?
De él.
Excellent. Her parents are doctors. Sus padres son doctores. ¿Los papás de quién?
De ella.
Excellent. Its title is misery. Su título es misery. ¿El título de quién?
De eso. De
¿y qué es eso?
Un libro, puede
un
ser.
Un libro, excelente. Our teachers are in a meeting. Nuestros profesores están en reunión. ¿Los profesores de quién?
Nuestros.
Otros.
Ok, no. Perfect. And their cats are in the park. ¿Los gatos de quién están en el parque?
De ellos.
De ellos. Perfecto. ¿Alguna pregunta o alguna duda?
No, teacher.
Ok. Ok, vale. Si por el momento no hay preguntas, perfecto. El día de mañana estaríamos retomando este tema y vamos a estar trabajando en ejercicios, ¿ok?
Okay, teacher.
So that's going to be all for me today. Thank you so much for coming and see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Good night,
teacher. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.